9, 8th grade, and I go to the Main Street Academy. Today, I will be talking about the importance of youth knowing and accepting God for themselves. In Matthew chapter 19, verse 14, Jesus told the disciples to let the little children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these. That scripture means he wants us to know as much about him as possible. We have many ways to learn about God and his will for us. As youth, we must take advantage of all the opportunities to hear God's message to us. We dance and sing and think it's all fun and games. Yet many of us don't know the story of King David and why he danced and sang songs to God. We need to understand the word of God, share the word of God, and live the word of God. We can say we believe in God all we want, but if we don't know the word of God, there's no point. This is why we should come to Sunday school to study different passages in the Bible. In today's lesson in Acts 8, we learned about Philip, one of the first appointed deacons in the church. God called Philip to teach a man from a different race and culture the good news of Christ. This led to a Gentile accepting Christ as his Savior. God's message is still spreading in this manner. This scripture reminds us how the Bible is still relevant in the world today. That is why knowing the word of God is so important. In Ephesians chapter 6, verse 4, it says, "And ye fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord." In other words, teach your children the word of God so they can be successful and obedient to his will. You also need to share the word of God. The reason Christianity is so widespread is because of sharing the word of God. Prophets have saved cities by speaking the word of God to his people. But when nations neglect the word of God, there is destruction. Like when the prophet Isaiah told the Israelites to stop worshiping idols and to worship God. When they did not listen, they were captured by the Babylonians for 70 years. We can't always rely on other people to share the word of God. We have to do it ourselves. If you share the word of God, you will be blessed by God. Also, you'll feel happy knowing you may have changed someone's life. When you are happy, God is happy. Make your life easier. So share the word of God. Once you know and share the word of God, you have to live it. Living the word of God is the most important part of Christianity that many Christians don't do. Living the word of God means applying it to everything you do. Once you do this, your life will be easier no matter what is happening. If you fail a test, don't like your teacher, or just have a bad time at school, if you have faith in God, you'll be fine. As a child, we also must trust our parents. They do everything for us, and we should not take that for granted. Living the word of God requires us to pray and seek his guidance to achieve our goals. The Bible was written thousands of years ago for our ancestors, us today, and our offspring in the future until he returns for his church. In conclusion, I encourage all you to attend Sunday school, children's church, and Sunday worship service to learn the word of God and share it with others and apply it to our daily lives. Thank you.